So we are discussing about the introduction and motivation of wireless communication, right? In which we have discussed that to transmit or receive voice and data using electromagnetic wave in open space is called as wireless communication. Voice and data. What is data? Email, stock quotes, cricket update, and so on. Nowadays, data traffic is much more than our voice traffic, right? And whatever information is sent from sender to receiver is carried over a well-defined frequency band. And that frequency band is called as a channel. Wireless communication is a multi-user system which wisely allocate channel among users, and different multiple access technologies are used to allocate the channel, right? Each channel has a fixed frequency bandwidth and capacity, which is bit rate, and these number of channels can be used to transmit the information from one place to another in parallel and independently, right? Next, if we assume that a service provider has 120 kilohertz spectrum is allocated over a base frequency for communication between station A and station B, and each channel suppose occupies 40 kilohertz bandwidth, then there will be three channels for which frequency range will be, for channel 1 it will be B to B plus 40, then B plus 40 to B plus 80, and B plus 80 to B plus 120. And as we can see that B plus 40 and B plus 80 frequency is common in between channel 1 and 2 and channel 2 and 3. So there will be overlapping of data of channel 1 and 2 and channel 2 and 3. So there should be a guard space between all the channels. And what should be the value of guard band? It will be decided by a filter, which is the front end at the side of receiver, right? Then how the guard band will be decided? Guard band is decided by the roll-off factor of the filter. Means it depends upon the order of the filter as well as the designing of the filter, that how sharp roll-off factor of the filter is. And guard band should be as low as possible so there is no wastage of frequency, right? And there should be guard band so that we can remove interference. So to make guard band, we have to design a very good filter of higher order, due to which the cost of the hardware will increase, and cost of the hardware and bandwidth both are required, right? So I have to keep a trade-off between cost of hardware and bandwidth. And let it be, if the system bandwidth is insufficient, then it is necessary to reduce the rate of information transmitted, right? This we have discussed in last class as well. And as we know that the type of the wireless communication, we can classify it as a mobile wireless communication system, then portable wireless communication system, and the fixed wireless communication system. In mobile, that is cellular phones as GSM, CDMA. Portable is your ultra wideband and Wi-Fi, which is 802.15.3 and 802.11.3. So these are the number of portable wireless communication systems. And in fixed, IEEE 802.16 wireless metropolitan area network. So there are number of wireless communication system examples are there, and which particular frequency is used for which application is given in this slide, in which we can see that FM radio works on typically 88 megahertz, TV on 200, GSM phone approximately 900 or 1800 megahertz, GPS 1.2 gigahertz, PCS 1.8, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi at the frequency of typical frequency of 2.4 gigahertz. This 2.4 gigahertz is a license-free band, so user can use 2.4 gigahertz frequency without paying anything to government or service provider because it is free, license-free band. And as we know, the partition of electromagnetic spectrum, we can divide it in low frequency, medium frequency, high frequency, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, super high frequency, and extreme high frequency. In this slide, the range for each particular frequency band is given. There's, for example, 30 to 300 kilohertz frequency is called as low frequency, then 300 to 333 megahertz as a medium frequency, and so on, right? As the propagation characteristics are different in each frequency band, so every frequency band has its typical characteristics, and because of that we have to use some techniques in that frequency range. How the power decides the transmission of wireless signal? So basically, as we can see, that let it be, there is a distance D between transmitter and receiver. For example, there is a distance D between transmitter and receiver, right? Then when we decrease our power, then the power received at a distance D1 is also decreased. So in general, if we, for example, that what is the maximum value of received power signal at a distance of D, it depends upon the transmitted power. If we increase our transmitted power, then this distance will also increase without attenuation. So for same power, if we increase the frequency, the interference will increase and coverage area will decrease. Right, so let us how the coverage area is decided. Right, the question is how the coverage area is decided. So for example, this is my tower, this is my base station, this is my base station and this is my mobile, right? So whenever I make a call, there is direct connection, radio connection between tower and my mobile, right? Suppose the signal which is transmitted by the tower has transmitted power PT, and at a distance of D, when I calculate the received power at the receiver, it is PR, and this PR is more than minimum signal level which is required to receive the signal properly, right? So now if we increase this distance, then the power received by this receiver will now decreased, and if it is less than minimum received signal strength, then the signal will be not received properly, right? So this distance at which we have getting the received power more than or equal to the minimum acceptable signal, then it will be called as the coverage distance, right? And if it is a isotropic antenna, then the radiation pattern will be circular. So this area will be called as the coverage area. Clear? Means what? Ki kisi time par agar
टावर जो है वो पीटी सिग्नल ट्रांसमिट कर रहा है, हम अपने रिसीवर को मूव करते हैं और उसकी जो डिस्टेंस है उसको इंक्रीज करते जाते हैं, देन जो पावर रिसीव्ड है रिसीवर पर वो डिक्रीज करेगी, ठीक है, वो डिक्रीज करेगी। तो कोई एक ऐसी डिस्टेंस मिलेगी जहां पर रिसीव्ड सिग्नल लेवल मेरा जो मिनिमम सिग्नल चाहिए कि अगर इससे कम सिग्नल की स्ट्रेंथ हुई तो हम रिसीवर पे सिग्नल को प्रॉपरली रिसीव नहीं कर पाएंगे, उससे ज्यादा है। यानी एवरी टाइम हमको जो मोबाइल पे रिसीव्ड सिग्नल है वो मोबाइल जिस मिनिमम रिसीव्ड सिग्नल स्ट्रेंथ पे काम करता है उससे ज्यादा पावर मुझे मिलनी चाहिए, ठीक। पर अगर उससे ज्यादा या उसके बराबर मिल रही है व्हेन आई मूव अवे फ्रॉम द बेस स्टेशन, देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज दैट मोबाइल स्टेशन इज इन कवरेज एरिया ऑफ दिस टावर, द मोबाइल स्टेशन इज विद इन द कवरेज एरिया ऑफ दिस टावर, एंड एज आई मूव अवे फ्रॉम द कवरेज एरिया देन द रिसीव्ड सिग्नल एट रिसीवर विल बी लेस देन द मिनिमम सिग्नल रिक्वायर्ड, जो मिनिमम सिग्नल चाहिए उससे कम है तो ये सिग्नल प्रॉपरली रिसीव नहीं हो। तो व्हाट इज द कवरेज एरिया, व्हाट इज द कवरेज एरिया, कवरेज एरिया इज द एरिया विद इन विच इफ आई मूव विद माय मोबाइल स्टेशन देन आई विल रिसीव द सिग्नल प्रॉपरली, मींस द रिसीव्ड सिग्नल एट द रिसीवर विल बी मोर देन द मिनिमम एक्सेप्टेबल सिग्नल एट द साइट ऑफ रिसीवर, क्लियर। This is called as a coverage area. This is called as a coverage area. This coverage area depends upon the transmitted signal strength. What is the signal strength of transmitted signal? Right? So if transmitted power PT, if we increase PT, whatever the signal is transmitted by this tower, by the antenna of base station, whatever the power is transmitted, we increase that power. It means what? We are increasing the coverage area of our base station. We are increasing the coverage area of base station. This tower is called as a base station, BASE. So, if we increase the power of transmitted signal, means we are increasing the coverage area of this base station. We are increasing the coverage area of this base station. Clear? So, it's very good. जस्ट यू इंक्रीज योर पावर, इंक्रीज करिए पावर लेवल को, इंक्रीज करिए ट्रांसमिटेड सिग्नल की पावर को, बढ़ाते जाइए कवरेज एरिया बढ़ता चला जाएगा। यानी मोबाइल कितना भी दूर जाए पावर लेवल बढ़ा लीजिए, मिनिमम सिग्नल लेवल मिलता रहे। बट हम ही एक अकेले तो नहीं है जो वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम को या GSM को यूज कर रहे हैं, देयर आर नंबर ऑफ यूजर्स। तो बाकी यूजर्स के लिए मेरा डेटा इंटरफियरेंस है, बाकी यूजर्स के लिए मेरा डेटा इंटरफियरेंस है, वो उनके लिए अनवांटेड सिग्नल है, वो सिग्नल को नहीं चाहते। तो अपने सिग्नल की स्ट्रेंथ को बढ़ाना, इट मींस वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द सिग्नल लेवल ऑफ नॉइज एंड इंटरफेरेंस आल्सो, वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द सिग्नल लेवल ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस आल्सो। तो इस तरीके से सिस्टम वर्क नहीं करेगा। तो देयर शुड बी अ ट्रेड ऑफ, देयर शुड बी अ लाइनअप कि कितना हमको ट्रांसमिटेड पावर रखना है, कितना कवरेज एरिया हमारा होना चाहिए, सो दैट हम दूसरे के लिए इतना इंटरफेरेंस ना प्रोड्यूस करें कि वो हम उसको रिमूव ना कर पाए रिसीवर साइड के ऊपर, ठीक है। तो ये पावर के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है कि क्या वैल्यू किस तरीके से हम लोग वर्कआउट करते हैं। अब जो सिग्नल हम ट्रांसफर कर रहे थे, सपोज पहले F1 फ्रिक्वेंसी पे ट्रांसफर कर रहे थे, अब हम F2 फ्रिक्वेंसी पे ट्रांसफर कर रहे हैं अपने सिग्नल को, तो क्या डिफरेंस आएगा? मीन्स इफ वी आर चेंजिंग द फ्रिक्वेंसी ऑफ ट्रांसमिटेड सिग्नल, पहले हमने पावर और ट्रांसमिटेड सिग्नल को चेंज किया, ट्रांसमिटेड सिग्नल के पावर को चेंज करने से मेरा कवरेज एरिया बढ़ता है, लेकिन कवरेज एरिया के बढ़ने के साथ साथ ही इंटरफेरेंस की वैल्यू भी बढ़ती है, राइट। इन द सेम पैटर्न इफ वी इंक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ अवर सिग्नल देन इंटरफेरेंस ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस, देन इंटरफेरेंस ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस, मीन्स द सिग्नल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द पावर विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज। As it is seen in the practical scenario, if we increase the frequency of the transmitted signal, then interference also increases, right? So, for example, if we are using the wireless communication system
GSM which is working on the frequency of 900 megahertz, then we get the coverage area of 5 kilometer. And if we increase our frequency, and now our frequency is in Bluetooth, which is 2.4 gigahertz frequency, then the coverage area will be decreased. It will be less than 5 kilometer. So basically, if we increase the frequency, coverage area will decrease. And if we increase the frequency, interference will also increase, right? So for example, if we are transmitting our data via a microwave link for 10 kilometer distance, right? For 10 kilometer distance, then higher the bandwidth, higher the data rate. Higher the bandwidth, higher the data rate. Means what? If we increase our high frequency, if we increase the frequency, means what? Suppose we have discussed that, just a minute, this is the electromagnetic spectrum, right? 900 megahertz lies in ultra high frequency, which is from 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz, 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. 900 megahertz lies somewhere there, okay? 900 megahertz. Now I have decided to move to super high frequency. Means hum GSM use karna chahte hain, par frequency ab use karenge 6 gigahertz, 7 gigahertz. To kya farak padega ki humne apni cellular ko yahan na karke agar hum super high phone mein kare, yani agar apni frequency ko increase karte hain to kya hoga? To frequency ko agar hum increase karte hain, dusre band mein jate hain, to mera interference bhi increase karta hai aur mera coverage area ki value decrease karti hai. Coverage area ki value डिक्रीज करती है, राइट? तो इन जनरल हम इंटरफेरेंस को बढ़ाना नहीं चाहते, इसलिए बहुत हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी को यूज नहीं करते. पर हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी का मतलब है कि हम लार्जर बैंडविड्थ को यूज कर रहे हैं, और लार्जर बैंडविड्थ का मतलब है लार्जर डेटा रेट. मीन्स हाउ मेनी बिट्स आर ट्रांसमिटेड इन वन सेकेंड, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ डेटा रेट. तो इन जनरल इफ वी यूज मोर बैंडविड्थ, लार्जर बैंडविड्थ, देन डेटा रेट विल बी हाई. तो मीन्स आप ये देखिए कि अगर हम अपना हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी की तरफ जाते हैं तो मेरी बैंडविड्थ बढ़ती है. बैंडविड्थ बढ़ने से मेरा डेटा रेट बढ़ता है, लेकिन उससे हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी पे जाने पे मेरा कवरेज एरिया कम होता है और इंटरफेरेंस की वैल्यू बढ़ती है. तो इन जनरल एक टिपिकल हर चीज़ों को लेकर के चलते हैं कि फ्रीक्वेंसी हाई है पर इतनी हाई नहीं है, इट इज 900 मेगाहर्ट्ज, इन विच वी आर गेटिंग the perfect value of coverage area as well as your interference as well as your data rate also, right? In general, propagation channels are different in each frequency band. Har frequency band mein usi wireless open channel ki characteristic alag alag hoti hain, jiski wajah se different services ke liye hum different frequency range ko use karte hain, right? So how the channel behave for a particular frequency band, upon this we will going to decide which particular application will lie on which particular band, right? Then this Maxwell's equations, we know initially Hertz validate the theory, and Marconi developed the first telegraphy instrument in 1928 with the TV broadcasting also. In 1973, the first handheld cellular phone came into the picture. 1981, 1G mobile, then 2G, then 2.5, 3G, 4G, etc. And up to the November 2004, there will be more than 45 million subscribers in globally. Then why wireless communication? The first thing is that we get the freedom from wires. There is no cost of installation of the wire, or there is no requirement of the rewiring, and there is no bunch of wire running from here and there, and it is automagical. There will be the instantaneous communication without setting any physical connection setup between transmitter and receiver, as example in Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, right? And wireless system also provides as global coverage, means communication can reach where wiring is infeasible or it is costly, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन रूरल एरिया, ओल्ड बिल्डिंग, बैटल फील्ड एक्सेट्रा. देन वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन गिव्स यू द फैसिलिटी ऑफ स्टे कनेक्टेड, मीन्स वेयर एवर यू गो द नेटवर्क फॉलोज यू, means you can connect it to your network in the roaming condition also. And there is a flexibility is there, means wherever you reach, wherever you go, connect to the multiple devices simultaneously, and there is no requirement of any physical connection setup before the transmission of data. So in general, why wireless communication? Number one, freedom from wires. Number two, global coverage. Number three, stay connected. Number four, flexibility. Right? And the basic mantra of the wireless communication is stay connected anywhere, anytime. Right? Then the challenges. Challenges is, number one is efficient hardware. We require low power transmitter receiver as well as low power signal processing tool so that talk time and the standby time of the same battery could be enhanced, right? The talk time and standby time. Talk time means if you connect it to the network and start the transmission of your data, then how long you can transmit your data without any interruption of battery, then it will be called as a talk time. And if we just on our mobile and leave it as it is, then the same battery will be discharged within a stipulated time, and that is called as a standby time. The second challenge is the efficient use of finite radio spectrum. So TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, gives a fixed radio spectrum to each service provider. Every service provider has a fixed amount of bandwidth, so we have to use it so that there will be maximum number of user can get the service. And there are number of techniques which is used for the efficient use of finite radio spectrum, which is cellular frequency reuse, media access control protocols, multiple input multiple output technique, which is also called as MIMO. So there are number of techniques which are used for the efficient use of finite radio spectrum. As well as the wireless system must support the integrated services. Integrated services means voice, data and multimedia over a single network, right? And service differentiation, priority, number of resource sharing must be provided by the wireless communication system. So it should support it. This is the number of challenges. As well as there are some more challenges, that as it is network support for user mobility, means when it is a mobile scenario, so where your mobile is situated at a particular time, it must be there. And to know the location identification and to start the service of handoff, means this is also one challenge. And to maintain the quality of service over unreliable link is also one challenge. Quality of service means, the quality of service is different for different type of people, right? Everybody has a different type of quality of service in his persona. The poor people has a different type of quality of service level, and for a rich person, quality of service is different. So in general, who is our user, depending upon that quality of service is maintained. And the quality of service depends upon the packet loss, the delay and the bit error rate, etc. parameters. Packet loss means if we transmitted our data in the form of a packet, then there is a possibility then some packet will be lost and it will never reached at the side of the receiver. So that will be packet loss, due to which the quality of service will decrease. Delay means if I transmit one packet, then after what time it will be reached at the receiver. एंड इफ द पैकेट इज रिसीव्ड एट द रिसीवर विद इन द टाइम लिमिट देन हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ बिट्स गेट एरर्ड दैट पैरामीटर विल डिसाइड द क्वालिटी ऑफ द सर्विस. सो बेसिकली क्वालिटी ऑफ सर्विस डिसाइडेड बाय पैकेट लॉस, डिले इन पैकेट एंड बिट एरर रेट एक्सेट्रा. So connectivity and coverage is also the challenge for the wireless communication, means internet working. In general, wherever you are, you want that there should be the lines of network shown on your mobile system, right? Either you are in the basement or inside the lift or in hilly region or within the valleys, everywhere the coverage is required. Everywhere there should be a connectivity from your mobile station to the service provider. This is the demand of today's wireless communication system. Already 95% coverage is provided by the service provider. So there is a requirement to provide the 99% of connectivity and coverage to the user. So this is the challenge for your wireless communication system. It's not only just we are connected via a wireless communication system. If I am explaining something or there will be some PPT etc., then it should be visible and audible to all the user. This is the challenge of wireless communication system, right? As there are some non-business challenges also, which are fading, multipath, higher probability of data corruption, and need for a stronger security mechanism. What is fading? For example, if transmitter transmits the signal, then maybe there is a direct connection between transmitter and receiver, which is called as a line of sight communication. Or maybe there is a non-line of sight communication, means there is no direct path between transmitter and receiver to transmit the data. Then there will be number of paths because of reflection, refraction and diffraction phenomena occurs, right? Means if there is a large building in the path of the signal, then the signal will be reflected by that building and reached at the receiver. The signal will be reflected by the ground and received at the receiver. The signal will be diffracted by a building which has a sharp edge. So because of that sharp edge, the signal will be diffracted by that building. So I will get number of copies of same signal at the receiver because of reflection, refraction and scattering and diffraction phenomena. So we are going to do the vector sum of all the received signal at the receiver, and whatever will be the resultant, that will be the received signal in amplitude, phase and frequency. So there is a small fluctuation, there is a small change in the amplitude of received signal. This is called as a fading. So basically, the number of multipath, the number of copies which I get at the receiver because of reflection, refraction, etc. So these number of paths will be called as a multipath, and the small fluctuation in the amplitude of received signal is called as fading. So the small rapid fluctuations in the amplitude of received signal, which is fading, it should not be beyond a particular value. It should not go beyond a particular value, so that we have to maintain a particular received signal strength at the side of receiver. So it is called as a fading. So because of fading and the multipath phenomena, there is a higher the probability of the data corruption. So we need stronger channel coding technique so that data can be corrected at the side of receiver if it is corrupted in wireless channel. So there is a need of a stronger security mechanism also to
to maintain the privacy of the user and the authenticated use of our channel. So these are the number of challenges. And wireless versus mobile. Wireless does not mean that it is a mobile. Mobile is always a wireless, but wireless does not necessarily mean mobile. Means if we connected two computer system wirelessly to each other, then it will be wireless, but it is not mobile, right? And this is a simplified wireless communication system representation that firstly, whatever the voice or data we have to transmit, that is connect, that will be generated and given to the coder, which provide you the channel coding and source coding at the voice and data which has to be transmitted. Then it will be given to the modulator where there is a requirement of a carrier signal, so that this information can be transmitted to a large distance. So it is fed at the feeder of the antenna by a power amplifier, and at the side of receiver, the antenna will connect to the demodulator decoding, and we will get our received signal at the side of the receiver, right? So this is basically shows you a simplified block diagram of a communication system, that what are the blocks taken into the picture for the transmitter, transmission and reception of an antenna, right? And at the side of the transmitter, we use a power amplifier so that the power of the transmitted signal should be increased up to some level. And at the side of the receiver, there will be a low noise amplifier is used, right? So that we can amplify our received signal before giving to the demodulator and decoding block. So this is a small introduction to the wireless communication system.